Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome to a new video. This is actually my first video because I've never made one before. I have COVID, and this is basically the diary of having COVID on your first week of the DCP, and that means the Disney College Program, if you don't know. So while I talk about my little story time, because I'm bored as shit, I'm gonna be playing Roblox, I'm gonna be playing Baldi's Basics, so enjoy. So basically, I lived in Jacksonville, which is in Florida, and I applied for this thing called the Disney College Program, which is in Orlando at Disney World. And basically you work at Disney and you work for Disney, do whatever they kind of assign you to do, and you get to go to the parks and stuff for free. And I don't know, it's a cool little program, and I'm doing it while I'm in school. We're in school for education right now, elementary education, so I can teach some kiddos in like 3 more years. But yeah, so I was supposed to move down here on the 28th, and I came down a day early because I was gonna meet with my roommate. She's flying in early, but then I ended up getting fucked. Her name is Ari. So her flight got like canceled like 3 times, and then so she was supposed to come down on the 26th, which is a Saturday. We moved in on the 28th. She didn't end up getting here until the 28th at 1 a.m. So the 26th and the 27th, I was just in Orlando, just chilling, by myself. So that was pretty cool. But I did that, and then she came in on the 28th, and we moved in earlier that day. So some people might know the Disney College Program is actually pretty popular. Fuck, I died. Oops. But it's actually pretty popular, but I know a lot of people don't know about it. So basically, the Disney College Program, you move to Orlando basically. You live in a Disney dorm for about 6 to 8 months, depending on the length of your program. Mine is from June 28th to January 27th. So mine's around an 8 month program, longer than others. Which I'm really happy about. So you do this thing called traditions, which is kind of like Disney's orientation, which is pretty cool. And that happens on the Friday after you move in, so you kind of have Monday through Friday, or Monday through Thursday at least, to kind of settle in and get used to everything, which is pretty cool. Yeah. Shit, this is so hard. This is harder than I thought it would be. I see people playing games and talking at the same time, and it looks so easy. But anyways, yeah, so let's talk about. Oh, I have COVID. So you might hear me sneezing, coughing the whole time. Sorry about that. Yeah, so I found out I had COVID. Today is Saturday. I found out I had COVID on Wednesday, Thursday? 3 days ago. So Thursday? Fuck, I don't know math, sorry. Thursday? Wait, no. I went to work Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Yeah, so it was Thursday. Let's talk about that little story, okay? It was pretty cool. Not really. So I'm vaccinated. I'm fully vaccinated. I have the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. So it's actually pretty fucking crazy how I got COVID, because I've tried to do everything in my power to make sure I'm safe and not trying to spread or keep this pandemic happening any longer. But I still end up getting it anyways, which is fucking bonkers. But so work. Okay, no. Sunday, July 4th, so Independence Day in America. We being me, my roommate Ari, and our friend Gina, we went to this place called Chef Mickey's, which is at the Contemporary Resort. If anyone knows, it's a Disney. Let me not. Sorry, I fell off this. God damn it. Sorry. Anyways, so Chef Mickey's. Yeah, it's like a restaurant, and it's in the Contemporary Hotel, and Resort. And we went to it. It's like a. It was like $60 per person, but it was really freaking cool. Buffet. Sorry, God. It's like a buffet. And you, like, they have a whole menu, and you just get everything from the menu. Like, their waiter brings it out to you, ask if you have any allergies and stuff like that, and then you get to eat from everything they bring out to you. And then you also get to choose if you want more or not, you can get that too. So it's like an all-you-can-eat buffet with a lot of stuff. It was really freaking good. We had prime rib and turkey, and oh my god, the turkey was so good. And I'm not usually a turkey bitch, but it was good. Also, speaking of food, on a little tangent, since I've been here, every morning I've been eating fucking avocado toast, and I'm usually not one of those bitches, but that shit is so fucking good, dude. And then, Ari, my roommate, she told me that I should put, everything bagel seasoning on it, so I did, and that shit is. That shit is good. Okay, so where was I? COVID. So we went to Chef Mickey's that Saturday night. Wait, no, Sunday night. Yeah, because it was the day before I started working. And then Monday I started training. It was only from like 10 to 2, and basically we showed up. They gave us a tour around the resort, which I work, man, I'm not good at telling stories. So I work at the Wilderness Resort, at Disney's Wilderness Resort, and I work quick service food and beverage. So I basically work in the few different restaurants and quick service places to serve food there. The main one I work at is called Geyser Point. It's a bar and grill outside. It's an outside restaurant, but I've been training in this place called Roaring Fork because of staff issues, you know, Disney, COVID shit, gang. But yeah, so we started training that day, and basically they just took us on a whole tour around the resort, kind of told us the backstory of it. I don't know if it's the real story, the fake story, because you know places have stuff like that. But anyways, they told us like what to say if a guest asked us any questions and blah 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 stuff like that. So we were doing that, and then I got home. I was feeling fine. I didn't feel too bad. Tuesday, my shift was from 6:30 to 2. I get home that night, and me and Ari order pizza. I'm feeling like shit after we eat the pizza, but I thought it was because I ate some jalapeno poppers, and that shit was spicy, and that it kind of like messed up my throat. So I thought that's what it was, and my throat was hurting then. So I was like, oh, it's the jalapeno poppers. And then the next morning, I'm like, oh, my throat's fucking hurting again. And I'm like, damn, this
shit kinda hurts.
And I'm like, man, maybe I burned the fuck out of myself with some jalapeno poppers. Maybe that shit, like, scalded my throat. So I get to work. I'm wearing my mask, of course, because I'm not feeling well, so of course I'm gonna wear my mask. I also have a nose ring too, so that's another pro. I always wear my mask because I'm not allowed to have my nose ring. I have a septum piercing. I'm not allowed to have it at Disney, but if I'm wearing my mask, I don't have to take it out, or I don't have to put it up in my nose, and it's just uncomfortable. So, I always wear my mask. But anyways, yeah. So I'm not feeling well. I'm talking to people about it at work, and they're like, oh, well, it's probably allergies, or you can, if you wore your mask all throughout the pandemic and you stopped wearing it currently, your body's not used to having certain bacteria in it again, so that's probably what it is. You probably just have like a little head cold. I'm like, oh shit, that makes a lot of sense. But then I went home and I talked to my roommate about it. She was like, actually, from a medical standpoint, that doesn't make any sense. And I'm like, damn it,
Damn
man,
it,
I thought
man.
I
I
was
thought I
onto
was on to
something.
something.
But no, so that night, I'm not feeling well at all. By the time, okay, so after work, I get home and I feel like absolute shit. Like, I feel like I just swallowed a whole pineapple or like a fork or some shit. My throat is in pain. And my nose is runny. And my eyes burn, so I think I had a fever. But I mean, I didn't have a thermometer, so I just kind of had to guess with that shit. So, is there a dog barking? What the dog doing? What the dog doing? Sorry. Anyways, shit, can I hop over this block? Please. Hop. Oh, no. Okay. Hop again. Let's. Okay. Ready? Set. Okay. Okay. Okay, now Juju on that. Okay. Anyways, where was I? Okay, my. So, anyways, I say I already call out of work for the next day because I'm not feeling well. And Ari's like, you should probably go get tested. I'm like, you know what? That's a good idea. So, we're wearing our masks in the house at this point because she's like, I don't want to get sick. And I'm like, I don't want you to get sick. She's also immunocompromised. So, it'd be way worse for her to get sick. So. We're both wearing our masks. We have Lysol wipes out the fucking yin yang, and we're wiping everything down. The next morning, that night, I'm like, oh, there's some 24-hour urgent care places. Let me go get tested. And then they're like, oh, yeah, well, we just ran out of COVID tests. So I'm like, okay. So I go home. And then the next morning, I wake up and I go. I'm feeling like absolute crap when I wake up, too. And I go, and they swab my nose. He's like, wow, you're a champ. You didn't even flinch. And I've had COVID tests 5 times because I always make sure that I'm not spreading this shit. And I've never had COVID. So I'm like, I tell him, like, yeah, I'm a boss. I've never had COVID and I've got tested enough times. I'm used to this nostril swabbing. And he's like, oh, well, you're vaccinated and everything. This should be a walk in the park for you. So I'm like, okay, hell yeah. He takes it back. He comes back a few minutes later and he was like, when did your symptoms start again? And I'm like, this day. And I give him a thumbs up and he kind of looks at me and I'm like, oh, that's a great sign. And then the doctor walks in. Damn, this shit glitchy. What? Damn. He's like, oh, yeah, so you're positive for COVID. And I'm like, oh my God. This has never happened. I'm sitting there thinking, I'm finna get my negative results, go out and get me a nice chicken nugget meal from McDonald's with a good large.
Sweet tea.
And go home and watch some TV and then go to work the next day. But no, that's not how it worked out. So I found out I had COVID. I immediately called my mom and I'm crying my eyes out because I'm like, I have COVID. What did I do wrong? And my mom's just telling me, like, oh, well, you didn't do anything wrong. I mean, you were tested and everything. There's nothing you really could have done. So I'm just chilling. But yeah, so I have COVID and that's my story. Hit me up on my social medias if you'd want to talk or something because I'm really, really bored. And I'm gonna be laying in my bed for the next 2 weeks. My Instagram, I'm gonna have it in my bio down below, but it's tortuga.tori. And my Snapchat is IROT-tori, so that's Tori backwards dash Tori. But yeah, it was really nice to meet you guys, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you for listening. Bye!